guys, how are you? It's Lindy and welcome to a new video! In today's video I've got another makeup tutorial for you guys. It's been a while. I've got lipstick on my teeth, I'm sorry. It's been a while since I filmed my last makeup tutorial. I actually can't even remember when I did that. It was a long time ago. So yeah, I'm back today with a makeup tutorial because the holiday season is coming up. Christmas is coming up, New Year's Eve is coming up, so I thought it would be nice to show you guys a makeup look that you can wear on these occasions. So this is a very grungy look, as you can see, but also pretty festive because I got two rhinestones underneath my eyes, so that makes it festive, I think. So yeah. So before I'm going to start this video, I just want to ask you guys to follow me on Instagram. Please follow me on my makeup Instagram, my normal Instagram, and on Twitter. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you haven't subscribed yet. And maybe even click that notification bell, because that would mean the world to me. So, yeah, now I've got that out of the way, I can just start this tutorial. So, enjoy this video. See you later, alligator. So, let's get started on the makeup. I already applied moisturizer, so now I'm just going to continue on some foundation. And for foundation, I'm using the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. I actually only recently bought this one, and I am so happy that I got it, because it is the perfect foundation for my skin. And I always have like a lot of trouble finding the right foundation. And this one is amazing. I love it. I only feel like it's a little bit too dark for my skin, like a tiny bit. If I'm wearing it like a low coverage foundation, so just like one layer, it's fine. But if I want to build it up to a high coverage foundation, then it is kind of too dark for me. But you know, I like my low to medium coverage more than my full coverage foundation, so it is okay. So yeah. Also, this foundation is only like 7 euros, which is so cheap. It honestly is the cheapest foundation that I've ever bought in my life, and I love it, so that's amazing. For my concealer, I'm using the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer, and I need to buy a new one because this one is almost empty, which sucks because this is super expensive, but okay. To set my foundation and concealer, I'm using the NYX SFX Setting Powder. I only use a tiny amount because I have pretty dry skin. So if I use a lot of powder, it's just going to emphasize all the dark patches on my skin. And that's not what I want, obviously. Then I'm going to contour my face using the NYX Cosmetics 3 Steps to Sculpt palette, and I'm using the one in Fair, and this one is actually still a little bit too warm for me, but I can make it work. So I'm just slightly contouring my face. I do really like this powder though, it's a very nice quality. The only problem that I have with contouring my face is that I am really white, as you can see. So my face always ends up looking pretty two-dimensional, so I actually need to contour a lot in order to just bring some dimension back into my face. But every time I contour a lot, it just looks like I have like dirt on my face because I'm so white. So every contour powder just ends up looking like dirt. So that kind of sucks, and I need to find a new contour powder, but for now I'm just using this one. So if anyone has like good recommendations for contour powders for very pale skin, please let me know, because I need one. For a highlight, I'm going to use my Sleek Solstice palette, and I'm just going to mix the golden one with a little bit of the orange one. Then continuing on the brows, I've actually been doing a new thing with my brows lately, because I was always trying to get those fleeky brows with, you know, with the brow pomades and stuff, but I just can't do that. I am terrible at doing brows, especially the fleeky brows, and I got so many people saying that I have ugly eyebrows, and I totally get that because I have really ugly eyebrows. So what I've been doing lately is trying to get like a more natural brow, So I'm just staying away from all the brow pomades because I just don't know how that works. And honestly, I don't even want to know anymore how it works. So what I've been doing lately is I've been filling in my eyebrows with eyeshadow. And then, let me get it. I've been putting some of the NYX 3-in-1 brow pencil thingy in black on top of my brows. So this is like a brow pencil thing, but it has three different things. So it has a brow powder. It has a brow pencil. And it has a brow gel. Ooh. So what I've been doing is filling in my eyebrows with a black eyeshadow. And then I've just been putting a little bit of this brow gel, this blackish brow gel, just a little bit through my brows to make them stay in place and to give them a little bit more definition. And I've actually really been liking this way of doing my brows. So that is what I'm going to do now. Ta-da! They are still really uneven, but I'm working on it, okay? So don't judge me, okay? Now we've got this all figured out. I'm just going to do this eye off camera. And then I'll be right back doing the other eye and showing to you what I did. So, see you in a second. Bye! Hey! I am back. I've done my eye, as you can see. I've actually done something different than I was planning on doing. I wanted to do something with glitters and I actually did that and it looked terrible. So I took it all off and then I did the exact same eye look but without the glitter. So this is what I have. So yeah, let's just get started on the eye. First off, prime my eyes using the NYX Proof It eyeshadow primer. Just all over the lid. I'm going to set that eyeshadow primer with a very light eyeshadow that kind of matches my skin tone. I'm taking my Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette and I'm taking the color Golden Ochre and a big fluffy brush. And I'm just going to use this as a transition shade. So I'm just putting it in the crease of my eye. And I'm going for a halo look, so I'm also bringing it in side of my eye as well, the inner corner. Then I'm taking a smaller brush and the color Raw Sienna and I'm going to put this in the outer corner and in the inner corner, and I'm just going to use this to darken up the eyeshadow. So placing it right here and placing it right here and I'm just going to blend that together. Then I'm just taking that brush that I used earlier and I'm just going to blend these two colors together a little bit. Now I'm taking a small pencil brush and I'm going to take the color Cypress Umber. And I'm using this to really darken up the look. So just put a little bit of that eyeshadow on your pencil brush. And then again I'm going to place this in the inner corner and in the outer corner. And then again, you kind of want to connect those at the top, right here. Taking a smaller brush and just blending it out a little bit. And then just reapply that color just to darken it up a little bit more. For my lower lash line, I'm just going back in with the Golden Ochre. And I'm going to smudge this under my eye. And I take it down pretty far because that's just gonna make it look a little bit more grungy and not so glam, because that's what we're going for. Also, this eye is watering like crazy, as you can see, and it's ruining my makeup. Everything is going great today. Then I'm just going in with that Raw Sienna color and I'm going to darken it up a little bit. Just like I did on the eyelid itself. And then with that pencil brush and the Cypress Umber color, I'm just going to darken it up even more. And for the lower lash line, I also wanted to have like that halo look. So I'm only darkening up on the sides, not on the inner part itself. And this is literally everything you have to do for the eyeshadow. So now I'm just going to continue on my lashes. I'm going to curl my lashes and then apply some mascara. And I'm also going to use some fake lashes. And for the fake lashes, I'm using the Red Cherry Berkeley lashes. And then to glam it up a little bit more, I'm taking a black little rhinestone and I'm just going to place that in the middle underneath my eyes, just like I had right here. So this is the entire eye look. As you can see, it is pretty cool. And then to finish it all off, I'm just going to put some lipstick on my lips, of course. And for that, I'm using the NYX Liquid Suede in Downtown Beauty. And as you can see, this is the smaller size because this one came from the Liquid Suede Cream Vault, which I actually did a swatch video on. So if you haven't seen that one, please watch it because my lips were chapped for 5 days after filming this video because it was so harsh on my lips. So I would really appreciate it if you guys watch it because I put a lot of effort in that video. So yeah, this was actually one of my favorite shades, so I'm just going to use it today because I love it. It's a very weird poopy brown color, but I like poopy brown, so yeah, I'm just going to put it on my lips. So yeah guys, this is the final look. As you can see, I put a beret on my head because I think it looks cute, so that's what I did. Yeah, this is the makeup tutorial on how to get this grungy but also kind of glam makeup look. I think this is perfect for Christmas or New Year's Eve, or just, I don't know, you could honestly wear it every day. I think it is such a cool look. I really like the dots under my eye, they just give it a little bit of festive feeling. And also this lipstick is gorgeous. Can you see it? I love it so much. So yeah, I really hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please don't forget to give a thumbs up. Don't forget to follow me on my makeup Instagram, my normal Instagram, and on Twitter. And I want to thank you guys for watching, and I really hope to see you in my next video. Bye bye.